cop's got there. He's driving somewhere.
That's just a strip.
This is for the tail. Okay. And this is cross cut. It's just a wrap in the body.
And you got to make sure you start to write that.
Yes.
So that it flows back.
Yes. And you split it and you wrap the, then you fold the top.
All right, so the stream.
You're doing stream. You're two. You're at night, shrimp are fishing. You're not done. Can you talk about that? Because he used to be wrapped around. In, but before you do that, you split these into equal parts like this. And you wrap the foam over the top, like that. And you bring your thread over the foam. It's kind of like a rip-off of a guard side minnow.
Does that foam?
Yes. It's a surface lure. And there's a video on the internet. It's Field & Stream's website. They actually show the guys that came up with this, and they actually show them fishing.
Well, let me just say it's really nice to be here at the Tye One On, sponsored by the Iroquois chapter of Trout Unlimited. Lots of good tires, and we all just, there's one big happy family. We borrow ideas from each other, and the fly that I'm about to tie for you today is no exception to that. This is a fly that I saw a video of just recently at the Field & Stream video website. It's a mouse pattern or a rat pattern, and these young guys were using it on the Delaware River to catch humongous trout. I couldn't believe my eyes, but we're all there throwing size 18 and 16 sulfurs, little tiny blue-winged olives, and we're getting refused, and we go home scratching our heads, when if we thought outside the box a little maybe and threw a rat pattern in a high water situation, we would might catch a big trout. So I'm going to tie that fly for you today. And it's very simple. It's kind of a borrowing from a lot of other tires like Jack Gartside. And, well, you'll see. It's a foam pattern. It's tied on a number two hook, which is pretty big. This is it's a sprout hook with a straight eye, kind of a medium wire. But who's going to use a two hook for a trout, right? So the first thing I'm going to do is start my thread. We're using a size A flat wax nylon, which is pretty stout, gives us a little authority. And then I'm gonna put a tail in, and the tail I made from a regular zonker strip where I gave it a haircut, and I ended up with something like this with a little tuft of hair at the end, but the rest of this is stripped of the fur, so we just have the hide and a little tuft. I'll get that established right now. That is the tail of the mouse. There we go. So secondly, I'm gonna cut a piece of closed cell foam. I'm using gray in this case. Oh, probably about, I don't know, a quarter inch wide, okay? And I'm gonna tie that in next by folding it actually over the hook itself. Tie that back right to where we tied in, where the tail begins at the bend of the hook. And then I'm gonna take another piece of rabbit hair, but this time I'm using the crosscut fur. Okay, the same type of coloration, but only in the crosscut variety, and that is used for wrapping the actual body. And the trick is to tie this in at the right point. You want to tie it in with the skin side down, hair side up, hair going back towards the bend of the hook. That's important. Hair going back towards the bend of the hook so that when you wrap it, you'll see the effect that you get. Otherwise, it wouldn't produce the proper mouse pattern that we're looking for. So when I do wrap this, skin side down, hair trailing towards the rear of the fly, see how that just naturally folds back in place? And these are crosscut rabbit strips. Okay, and the chinchilla, I happen to be using a gray chinchilla. I give that about 4 or 5 wraps, I tie that off, leave enough space behind the eye, like in any good fly pattern, get that established, and I'll cut that. Now we take this foam and we fold it over, but before we do that, we separate the fibers so that half are going one side of the one side of the mouse and the other half are going to the other side of the mouse. So I separate those fibers like that in such a way. Then I bring the foam over, a la Jack Gardside Gurgler. We wrap that into place. Got a few wraps. Now, I made a little addition of my own. Like I said, we borrow from all other tires. I'll take a little Zappa Gap. I'll cut a foam cylinder like so. This, it's a fluorescent green foam cylinder. And I'll take a little Zappa Gap, add it to just right there. That fortifies the fly. I'll take that little foam cylinder and I'll set that in place. Then I'll fold that over such a way. And then I'll actually wrap behind those eyes, creating a head and also creating ears. You'll see in a minute. Let's whip finish that now. Very simple to tie, very light fly. You can throw this with a 5-weight. I would suggest 2X leader. Go to the Field & Stream website, see the boys that are actually fishing this darn thing. You'll know what I mean. Not doing a very good job with the whip finish tool today. There we go, we got her. Okay, trim that. And I'm also gonna put some glue on the bottom of this too, a little more Zappa Gap. But now we'll just trim the ears. It's nice getting your ears trimmed. And there you have it, there's your mouse pattern. And again, a little dab will do you right at the bottom of this fly, right there, just to really secure those wraps. But essentially, this is something that a big trout will eat, will actually go after it aggressively. And when you see the video, you'll know what I mean. I'm Al Dayer with Mickey's Bait and Tackle. And today we did a mouse pattern. You can do these in black, you can do them in brown, you can do them in gray. I'd say think outside the box a little next time you're fishing for some big trout and go try this out for size. Hey, John.
Bigger than I've gotten on a fly. I'm out of a boat. This is my best baker on a fly out of the boat.
And that's a 25-pound fish?
At 20.
Sure, we're saying April. I saw one leg, drop it down so I can put it easy in the vise. How big a fly you make, you still have a short shank of white gap.
I know, Sheldon. It seems like
standard white out on the birch.
Okay.
We need to separate. That's why he didn't want to speak. He sat there and they counted through the counter. He didn't want to took my book. The guy called for a
long life. When we came back from that show,
he looked like Admiral Murray.
Well, that sort of thing. So the more in situation.
Generally, I would fish this.
Everything. It's good, good. Yeah, it's been a while. I know we've been.
Oh, you recording?
I get this guy every year. We'll get this guy.
It's a nice one. I'm gonna give you a large newsletter. I know what I'm gonna do. What I'll do is make a special kid's
graph. Hi, I'm David Figura, outdoors writer for the Post Standard, and I'm at the Tye One On Rendezvous at Barbagallo's restaurant in East Syracuse. There's a crowd here of about 140 today, and 40 different fly tires, and I'm here selling my book, So What Are the Guys Doing?, which is about my midlife crisis, things I went through in my interviews with 50 guys between the ages of 40 and 60, on everything from sex, friendship, loneliness, to the younger woman thing, to the middle-aged boogeyman, which is fear of being laid off or fear of taking a risk in your career. And one of the things I'm writing about in the book is why I became the outdoors writer. And it's worked out well for me, and that's why I'm here today, to pass the word on that you need to take a risk at times if you're unhappy. It's not going to happen unless you do it. I did, and that's why I'm here today.
Yeah, it's amazing how this fits into the fly fishing, fly tying theme.
Right.
As far as men or women being able to get with nature.
Yeah. I think it really does fit in. But the one thing that I concluded on my 40th birthday, I got the book, Fly Fishing Through Your Midlife Crisis, is that no amount of fly fishing by myself was going to make my life better. I needed to have friends to go fly fishing with. And that's an important fact, that good friends make for a good life. And if no other message gets through on my book, that point I hope to make and continue making.
Boy, that's a truthism if there ever was one, because in the old days when I was a youngster, I liked fishing alone.
Right.
But now that I'm in my 60s, I don't like fishing alone. I want to be with my buddies.
Exactly. And that for me is a crucial thing. And becoming the outdoors writer, it seems like I have no shortage of people who want to go fishing with me, which is quite a change from when I first started this book, before I was the outdoors writer. But it does make a difference that, you know, enjoying doing something outdoors with someone you really like as a friend really enhances the experience.
You know, fly tying too is kind of a social endeavor.
Right.
A lot of these people here all know each other.
Right.
And they share secrets with each other and tie flies for each other. And that's a big part of it, I think. We're not all just little islands doing our own little thing here today.
Right. And the thing is, I would recommend if you're going to get into fly tying, one of the big things you should do is hook up with someone who's an expert fly fisherman, fly tier. And they'll help you along, and you'll enjoy the process a lot more rather than just trying to learn everything from books and videos. And if you'd like a copy of my book, So What Are the Guys Doing?, go to my website, davidjfigura.com.
And then this is in Camden. I think there was like 25, 24,000.
Pretty elaborate setup, you guys.
Yeah, I mean, this is the hatchery. You can see. And then,
Nicole from the Guild gave his number about
time.
Yeah, John Hatton, yep. He was supposed to come today, but he had something wrong with his truck, he said. Okay, just number. Yeah, comfortable. I don't have anything on there. So I can leave.
Hi, this is Sean LeVanture with Madison County Trout Unlimited. We are here today at the Tye One On event. We are having a great time here. We've gotten a lot of traffic, talking to a lot of new people. We're trying to get more membership for our chapter. Madison County Trout Unlimited is a chapter located primarily in the Chittenango area. That's our home stream. And we do several programs in that area. We do trout stocking, of course, in coordination with the DEC and the hatchery out of Rome. We have a few programs that are gaining more interest every year. We have a fly tying program that we do in the winter. We consider it an apprenticeship program. That's from ages 8 to 80. We welcome all sorts of age groups. And we also have, in the springtime, we do a fly fishing seminar, a class. We teach people how to mainly cast the fly rod. We do go into a little bit of detail about stream entomology and the techniques of fishing, but it's more than anything, it's a casting lesson for us. We also have programs such as Trout in the Classroom. We try to introduce young kids in school, different grade levels. We introduce them both eggs and also small fry. And we're always looking for new members. So if you can look us up, we're on the web. TU680.org, and you can find more information on our chapter. You can come to our meetings. We welcome all the public to our meetings. We typically have a very interesting speaker at times that's typically fishing related, outdoor related. We try to not just do fishing, we try to get interest of all different groups. So come and check us out. We'd be glad to take you on as another member or get involved with any of our programs. We look forward to seeing you. Thank you.